to beam or not to beam. That is the purpose of today's lecture. Beams. So far, we've talked about lots of different stuff. And today's lecture is going to be a culmination of all of those topics to understand and do some equations involving beams, which are structures that are literally all around us. Today, we're going to combine the things that we've learned in force vectors, moments, free body diagrams, supports, and our systems of equilibrium to come together and work on solving some ENIAS 102 static problems that are called rigid body equilibrium problems. Let's get started.
To get things started, we'll look at the following example problem, which shows a beam supported by a pin at A and a cable at B. We'll go through how to set up a free body diagram and the system of equations to solve this problem.
Okay, everyone, let's check out this 2D equilibrium example problem. What we can see is that we've got a beam attached with a pin support at point A and a cable at point B up to the roof over there. We can see that the cable is inclined at an angle of 3, 4, 5, similar triangle. So that's going to be useful in helping us solve the problem. We're also given the dimensions, and we have an applied force of 500 newtons applied to the beam, 3 meters from the left side. The question asks us two things. This is a very typical setup to most of these types of problems. Is it asks us to solve for the reactions at point A, so what are the forces applied by the pin, and what are the forces in the cable to keep the system in equilibrium and at rest. So, the first step that we want to do in this problem is to draw our free body diagram. Because as we've said, drawing a free body diagram is going to help us set up the problem and figure out what our next steps are. So, I'm going to draw the free body diagram, and then we'll go from there. Now I've drawn the free body diagram, and what I've done is I've replaced the pin support at A with two forces, AX and AY, and it doesn't matter whether you draw those up, down, left, or right, it'll all work out in the end. I've drawn them up into the left because I'm assuming that AY is going to be fighting this downward force, and because I have this tension B, which I know can only pull going to the right, I'm assuming that the force AX is going to go to the left. So what's our next step? Now that we've got this all set up, thing that we want to do is use our system of equations, the sum of the forces in the X and the sum of the forces in the Y, to solve. So let's get that process started. So what you can see now is that I've written out the sum of the forces in the X and the sum of the forces in the Y equations. If we look at the sum of the forces in the X, we have two unknowns. We don't know AX. And we don't know TB either. So that equation isn't particularly useful for us right now. In the y direction, we don't know AY. We don't know TB. And we do know the 500 newtons. So if we look here, how many unknowns do we have? The things that we don't know, and that we need to solve for, are AX, AY, and TB. Well, if you look at that, that's three things, if you can count good. So if we have three things to solve for, we need to use three equations. So we're actually going to need to use the sum of the moments equation to solve this problem. And how's that going to work out? When you're doing a sum of the moments, what you want to do is you either want to do it about point A or point B over here. The reason being that if you do it about one of those points, you can get rid of the unknowns, because at that point, the force will go through the pivot point and won't be included in the equation. I'm going to do the sum of the moments about point A because we have two unknown forces there. So it's going to make our lives a lot easier to eliminate AX and AY by doing a sum of the moments about point A. I'm going to write that up on the board right now. So now I've got the sum of the moments equation about point A. And the only things that matter in the sum of the moments about point A are the 500 newtons times 3 meters, which would cause a clockwise rotation about point A, and the Y component of TB. The X component of TB actually goes through the pivot point A. So we don't have to include that. The only thing that we include is the y component. So looking at this equation, how many unknowns do we have? We have only one unknown right now. Therefore, we can actually solve this equation right here. So what we'll get from this is if I erase these question marks, we have 1500 equals to 3 times TB, because our 5s will cancel. What this tells us is that TB is equal to 500 newtons. All right, now that we have solved for TB, there's only two things left that we need to do, AX and AY. And because we now have two equations and only two unknowns, the AX and AY forces, we can actually solve by plugging in our value for TB into those equations. If we look, we can plug TB in right here. AX then is going to be equal to 500 times 4/5. Well, 500 divided by 5 will be 100 times 4 is 400. So what AX is equal to is 400 newtons. And if we plug TB into right here, we will get 500 divided by 5 multiplied by 3. This becomes 300 plus negative 500 equals AY. So AY is going to be equal to 200 newtons. There you go. That's how you approach a 2D equilibrium problem, particularly for a rigid body. You draw your free body diagram to model the system, you write out the equations, and see where you need to go in order to solve. In this case, because we had three unknowns, we needed to write three equations, the sum of the forces in the X, the sum of the forces in the Y, and in particular here, some of the moments about point A. That way we could eliminate two unknowns and get an equation that had only one unknown that was solvable. Let's do another example problem to continue to move on and learn more about 2D rigid body equilibrium.
Before I go over the solution to this problem, I want you to try and take a crack at it. Take everything you just learned from the previous slide and try and apply it here and see if you can apply those concepts to this particular example. In this question, it's asking you to solve for the reaction at point A and at point B. So, set up your free body diagram and your systems of equations and see if you can solve for the unknowns. Take a minute, pause your video, and work on this problem, and I'll go over the solution.
Let's look at this other 2D rigid body equilibrium problem to continue to practice this content. Here what we see is another beam with a pin at A and a roller support at point B. We can see that we've got two forces applied. F1 is 8 kilonewtons, and F2 is 3 kilonewtons, pointed up and to the right at an angle of 60 degrees. Our question here, very typical, solve for the reaction forces at point A and point B. So our first step is to draw a free body diagram, a good old FOOD. Let me do that right now. Now that we've got the free body diagram drawn, so our next step is to write our system of equations out, the sum of the forces, the X, the Y, and possibly some of the moments. Really quick, I guess what we could identify here is how many unknowns do we have? AX is going to be unknown, AY is going to be unknown, and the force of the roller, which remember, a roller can only ever point up, is BY, is also unknown. So what you can see is actually we have three unknowns in this question. As a result, we are going to definitely need to do a sum of the moments. So we might as well just do that first, because as we saw in the last problem, it's actually very useful to do sum of the moments to get a force and then solve everything much quicker. So let's write a sum of the moments about point A. That way we can eliminate two unknowns, AX and AY, and solve the problem. I'm going to write out the sum of the moments equation right now. Now what you can see is I've written out the sum of the moments equation here. We've got our value of 8 times 3, and that's going to go clockwise, as we can see right here. So I've included it to be negative. We've also got force F2 going up and to the right. Now, the force that's going to the right isn't going to matter in our moments equation, because again, that passes through the point of rotation at A. Our y component of force actually will matter, though, and is a distance starting from here, 6 meters away. So what we're going to have is a value of 3 sine of 60, using our force vectors to find the y component, multiplied by the value of 6, which is the distance away from that pivot point. Because remember, moments are equal to force times distance. And last but not least, we also have by times 9. That is our force of the roller multiplied by 9 meters, then it's going to force this beam to want to rotate counterclockwise. That is the only unknown we have in this equation, so we can now solve by doing some simple algebra. So by doing a little bit of algebra, we can see that by times 9 is equal to 24 minus 15.6. When we solve, we get that by is equal to 0.9 kilonewtons. Now what we need to do is solve for the sum of the forces in the x and the sum of the forces in the y to get ax and ay. Now I've written the sum of the forces in the x and the sum of the forces in the y equation. And as you can see, the sum of the forces in the x, we have the ax plus 3 times cosine 60, which is our F2 and the force of our pin, our only two x forces. We can quickly solve this because we have only one unknown, which is ax. So we can solve and say that ax is equal to 1.5 kilonewtons. Now the only thing we have left to do is the sum of the forces in the y. We can plug in by from above, and then we have ay going up minus 8 plus 3 sine of 60, the y component of F2, plus by, which goes up as well. And when we do all of the math there, what we get is that ay is equal to 4.5 kilonewtons. There you go. That's another example, in this case, where we had a pin and a roller and two forces, one that was inclined, and how you approach a 2D rigid body equilibrium question.
Now we're going to look at this 2D rigid body example problem, which is very similar to the ones that we've just done. Here, you can see that we've got a pin supported A and a roller supported B, and we have an inclined force located in the middle. The only difference between this problem and the ones that we've done thus far is that we have a new thing that we haven't yet seen, which is that we have a point moment on the far right end of the beam. Let me show you how to approach this problem and the solution in just a second, but before we get there, I want you to pause your video and at least draw a free body diagram of this example. Then, what we'll do is I'll show you how to address point moments in these types of problems.
Here we have another 2D rigid body equilibrium problem. In this particular case, we have something we haven't yet seen, which is over on the right edge of the beam, which is a point moment. So, how are we going to deal with that? Let's find out. What we can see is in this particular question, we're asked to solve for the reaction forces at A and B. At point A, we have a pin, which is going to have two reaction forces, and at point B, which is a roller, we're going to have one. That tells us we have three unknowns in our particular question, AX, AY, and BY, just like we have in the previous questions. So we are at some point going to need to do a sum of the moments. And that's especially going to be true because we have this point moment at the end. Something else we can also notice is that the units in this question aren't newtons or kilonewtons, but they are pounds. So the first step in all statics questions is going to be to draw a free body diagram, and that's what I'll do now. Set up and drawn our free body diagram, drawn our xy axes, put all the dimensions and all the forces modeled in our system. Now what we have to do is we have to do a system of equations, some of the forces, the x, the y, and the moments in order to be able to solve this question. Let's get started off with the sum of the forces in the x. What we can see here now is that I've set up the sum of the forces in the x equation to show all the forces that we have in the x. The first force you can see in this equation is ax, which I've delineated as negative because ax points to the left over here. The other force is the x component of our applied force, and I've put down that it's 500 times 3 over 5. The reason is because of similar triangles. you can see that the x component of the small triangle is 3, and the hypotenuse is 5. Therefore, to get the x component, which I've drawn here with this blue dotted line, is to multiply 500 times 3 over 5. What this leaves us with is a fairly straightforward equation. Ax is going to be equal to 500 times 3 fifths. Therefore, Ax is going to be equal to 300 pounds. Now what we're going to need to do is a sum of the forces in the y equation to solve for all of the forces in the y. Let me write that up on the board. Now that I've written up the sum of the forces in the y, we can see that that equation has two unknowns. We don't know Ay, and we don't know By. This tells us that we're going to have to do a sum of the moments in order to be able to calculate one of the unknowns. Usually, you do it about the pin because that has two forces involved. So that's what I'll do now, is I'll write up the sum of the moments about point A so we can get rid of Ay from our equation and solve for By. All right, now I've drawn the sum of the moments equation here. And what we can see is that we've got our applied force, 500 times 4 fifths, because we care about the y component, multiplied by its distance of 5 feet. We're also going to have By, which goes here, and is going to cause things to rotate counterclockwise, multiplied by a value of 10, and here's how we deal with the point moment. We just put it in. We've got 600 pound foot going clockwise, which will indicate right here as being another negative moment. So now what you can see is that we have only one unknown in this question here, which is By, which is going to allow us to solve for that unknown. Now that we figured out that By is 260 pounds, we can take that, plug that back into the sum of the forces in the y equation, and solve for Ay, our last unknown. And when we do that, we will get a value for Ay equal to 140 pounds. There you go. That's how you deal with several different types of 2D rigid equilibrium problems. And hopefully, things are a little bit more clear and you've had an opportunity to practice through things and see how all the concepts we've learned thus far apply.
Beams are structures that are everywhere. They hold up buildings small and large, from our homes to even football stadiums and college dormitories. ENEAS 102 includes material that is literally all around you. Pay close attention and look around in your everyday life to see if you can find beams as well.
That concludes today's lecture on 2D rigid body equilibrium. Thanks for watching.
In addition to making all these incredible ENEAS 102 lecture videos, I've also been working on some pretty revolutionary technology based on Star Trek. And I think it's finally ready to show off. All right, Scotty. Beam me up.